Pass it that way. Pop quiz for the end of 1982, and on this one the teams are skippered by Hank Marvin and David Essex. First of all, let's meet David's team, and they are Mary Wilson, Leo Sayer, and their skipper David Essex. Hank's team are Captain Sensible, from Duran Duran, John Taylor. And their skipper from the Shadows, Hank Marvin. Well, amongst the questions on Pop Quiz, a question set specially by Paul McCartney and Ringo Starr. Those coming up a bit later. We kick off, first of all, with an individual round about this year's hits. Mary, you're first. Here's some film for you of Dexter's Midnight Runners. That's Dexys with a cover version of Respect. This year they had a hit with a song that was originally written and recorded by somebody else. Who was it?
Van Morrison.
Van Morrison, and the song was?
Jackie Wilson Said.
Jackie Wilson Said, well done, 2 points, yes. Over to Captain Sensible now. Something coming up for you. I must point out that during the quiz, any that you don't get right, I've got some spray string here, and everyone you get wrong, you'll get a little burst. So here's some film for you of madness.
Driving in my car. Look much, but I've been far. I drive up to Maswell Hill. I've even been to Selsey-ville. I drove along the A45. I had a rap 258.
That's madness driving in my car. Captain, can you name... It's been eating the props again. Can you name two other madness hits from this year?
Our House.
Our House is one.
I don't know why you invited me on this programme, because I know nothing about music.
You've already got...
I spent 6 years in the den.
You've already got half of it right. There were two more.
Freddie Frinton's Earplug.
No, you got half right, so I'll just give you a... I'll just give you a short verse this time. The others... The others were House of Fun and Cardiac Arrest. So 1 point out of two, and over to skipper David Essex. A bit of shaky coming up for you, David. Right, David, that's shaky. He's currently having a blue Christmas. Who originally had a hit with Blue Christmas?
Elvis.
For 1 point, in which year for the other point?
Now, let me think. I think that would be about 1961.
No, I'll give you 1 point, 64.
Is it really? Mm.
Hank, some Kid Creole the Coconuts coming up for you.
I got a lady,
OK, that's Kid Creole. Hank, what's his real name?
Cliff Richard.
There is a passing resemblance, isn't it? His other real name?
No? You should have a spray for that.
The answer is Auguste Darnell.
Serves him right.
Right, Leo, your turn. Here's a bit of Eddie Grant coming up for you. Okay, Leo, which 60s group did Eddie Grant first chart with?
Actually, I know him because he goes to my hairdresser. he's with the Equals. He was with the Equals.
The Equals, that's right. Black Skin, Blue Eye Boys, Viva Bobby Jones, Baby Come Back. Finally, in this round, John Taylor, a clip of Roxy Music for you. Okay, that was More Than This by Roxy Music. For 1 point, first of all, can you name me their very first hit single?
Virginia Plain.
Virginia Plain. The second part and their last hit single?
Take a Chance.
No, it wasn't. It was Avalon. It was Avalon. So 1 point out of two.
John,
see how sympathetic they are. At the end of round one, Hank's team have two, David Essex team five. Round two is a team question. 5 points for a right answer. In honour of the Beatles' 20th anniversary this year, this is all about the Beatles. I'm going to show each team three pieces of film, and I want you to tell me which year the songs were hits. They're all the same year, right? You hear three songs, they'll all be the same year. Hank, your team first.
From Paris to the Amsterdam Hill.
You're right, it was 1969. It was Get Back, Ballad of John and Yoko, and Come Together, which was a double A-side with Something. So you have your full 5 points. Same for your team, David. Three Beatles songs, all from the same year. Okay, three Beatles songs, which year?
We think 1964.
You'd be right in saying 1964, yes. So it's Hard Day's Night, and I Feel Fine were hits in 64, and She Loves You, although to be number one in 63, came back into the charts in 64. So 5 points to you. The end of round two, Hank's team have seven, David's team 10. In the lyric round, they're all this year's hits, so they should be incredibly easy. Right, Mary, you're first to go. Where do these two lines come from? There's one thing, yes, one thing, that turns this grey sky to blue. There's one thing, yes, one thing, that turns this grey sky to blue.
Tip of my beehive.
It wasn't. It wasn't Andy Stewart, was it?
It wasn't.
I'm awfully sorry, but I'm afraid I just don't know.
I'm going to have to tell you that Martin Fry and the group were ABC.
It's one thing. It's one thing that turns this.
And the look of love, so no points there. Captain, some lines for you. Biddly, biddly, biddly. Biddly bomb.
It had to be Bob Dylan or Bruce Springsteen.
It was, in fact...
Biddly, 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 biddly bomb.
Musical youth. I thought you were going to guess Rolf Harris, to be honest. No points there. David, some lyrics for you. You don't drink, you don't smoke. What do you do?
That's Goody Two Shoes by Adam Ant.
Goody Two Shoes, Adam Ant, yes, good luck. Hang over to you. Where have you heard these lyrics before? It's a mystery to me. The game commences for the usual fee, plus expenses.
Private Investigations, Dire Straits.
By Dire Straits, well done, 2 points. Leo, you recognise these lyrics. Standing in the door of the Pink Flamingo, crying in the rain.
I don't know which song it is, but I have a feeling it's something that Mark Almond sang. It's a soft sell.
Finally in the lyric round, John, where are these lyrics from? Just when I thought I could not be stopped, when my chance came to be king. Oh, stop cheating!
Japan and ghosts.
Japan and ghosts, 2 points. Yeah. At the end of round three, Hank Marvin's team 11, David Essex team 14. Okay, the cover version's round coming up, round four. All the songs are Beatles songs, but the three versions you're going to hear are not by the Beatles. In fact, they're very hard. Captain Sensible, it's you to start. Three versions coming up. Three versions coming up, and we can work it out.
I have to keep on talking till I can't go on. Well, you see it your way. Run the risk of knowing that our love will soon be gone.
We can work it out. We can work it out.
Think of what I'm saying. You can get it wrong. Still you think that it's all right. Think of what I'm saying. You can work it out and get it straight or say goodnight.
We can work it out. Three versions of that. Captain, you know who they were?
No. Didn't know the first one at all.
Right.
I think the second one was Billy Preston, stroke Stevie Wonder, stroke...
Who do you think the third one was?
Dolly Parton.
Right.
No.
In fact, the second
one
was...
It was close, though, wasn't it?
The second one was Stevie Wonder. The third one was Melanie.
You said that.
I said that.
Yes, but it was one of the three you mentioned. I'll give you... Captain, you have 1 point out of a possible three, although heaven knows how. Marry, three versions for you of a John Lennon song.
Imagine no possessions. I wonder if you can.
No need for greed or hunger. The brotherhood of man.
Say I'm a dreamer. Marry, three versions of Imagine.
Right. Randy Crawford was the first one.
Right.
Diana Ross was the third one.
Right.
The middle one, I really don't know. George Benson, I guess.
A sensible guess. It was Benny King with the Average White Band. So 2 out of 3. Well done. And now, Hank, three versions of Lady Madonna for you.
Lady Madonna, children at your feet. Learn to tie his boots.
Okay, Hank, three versions of the Lady Madonna. Who were they?
Well, the first one was either Blood, Sweat and Tears or David Clayton Smith, is it?
Thomas.
I would say the first one was wrong. Do you want to move on to the second one?
Yes. Now, I didn't hear any vocals on the second one.
You're quite right, there weren't any. I think I'm going to give you a point for spotting that. That's one point.
Booker T, the MGs.
You're right, for a point.
Thank you. The third one was In and Out Like a Flash.
Who was it?
I don't know.
It was the chap who sang it first time round. It was Paul McCartney, only this time with Wings. So you have a point for Booker T, a point for spotting. There were no vocals on the instrumental. And we're going to move over to David Essex. David, who are these people?
We're back in the USSR.
Back in the USSR. David, while you're having a think about that, I will say the first one of yours, Hank, in case you didn't know what it was Gary Puckett and the Union Gap. That's given David another couple of seconds to have a think.
The first one I don't think I know. I thought the second one was Elton John.
You're right, for a point it was. Yes, Live in Russia.
And the last one, I know the voice, but I can't quite get the name.
It was Chubby Checker, the third one.
That's it. I knew the voice, yeah.
And the first one was Cliff Bennett and the Rebel Rousers. Yeah. So one out of three for you. John Taylor, three versions for you of Here Comes the Sun.
Little darling, the star was returning to the faces. Little darling, it seems like years since it's been here.
Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun. And I say, it's all right.
Little darling, it's been a long, cold and lonely winter. Little darling, it feels like years since you've been here.
Three versions of Here Comes the Sun. Do you know who they were?
The first one was Steve Harley and Cockney Rebel.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Second one was Richie Havens.
You're right.
The third one, I haven't got a clue.
Well, you're right, and Steve Harley for 1 point, Richie Havens for 1 point, and the third one was Nina Simone. And lastly in this round, Leo Sayer. Leo, let's see how you do. Right, three versions of I Want to Be Your Man. Who was the first one?
I think it was Susie Quattro.
It was Susie Quattro. Yes.
And I have a sneaking feeling the second one was Mr. Rubber Lips himself, Mick Jagger, at the stand.
Quick impression?
Yeah. I can't do it. I can't do it today. I'm off. I'm on a rest from the Stones today.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
All right.
I'm doing Michael Crawford, though. Where we repeated and repeated,
yes,
and ran out of steam. Was that the Monkees?
It wasn't. It wasn't the Monkees. It was. It was your manager, Adam Faith.
I'll never talk to him again.
Well done, Leo. At the end of that round, Hank's team 16, David's team 19. Right, round five is a compilation round, and you can all confer on this. More songs by the Beatles and also solo Beatles, this time actually performed by them. We've compiled 10 bits of songs for both teams to identify, so you can all confer. Pens at the ready to write down the titles of these tracks.
Oh,
10 tracks by the Beatles or solo Beatles?
Okay, Hank, you fire away and tell me which ones you have.
Well, the first one was Ringo, Back Up Boogaloo.
Okay, I'll tell you whether you're right afterwards.
Back Up Boogaloo, Live and Let Die, Hey Jude, My Sweet Lord, Norwegian Wood, When I'm 64, I'm the Walrus.
You missed out Maxwell Silver, Amy.
Hang on. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. You're right, we've missed out one. Maxwell's Silverhammer.
I got one. Go on.
Well done, well done. Can you have another score? Did we get an eye on the Walrus?
You got to that
we
one,
did.
Yes.
Then I think it was the intro to 8 days a week. Then going home. The last one.
OK, I'll tell you how many you have at a moment, David.
Yeah, if I can read Mary's cassettes... Marriage.
She did Marriage, the best
you
mean Marriage,
I do, Bill, yeah. Back Off Boogaloo, Live and Let Die, Hey Jude, My Sweet Lord, Maxwell Silverhammer, Norwegian Wood, When I'm 64, I Am the Walrus, 8 days a week. And the Paul McCartney track, we've got Two of Us.
You're right, it was Two of Us. It wasn't called Going Home, it was Two of Us. So you have 10, Hank's team has 9. And at the end of round 5, Hank's team has 25, David's team 29. But anything can happen in the final round. It's a quick-fire round, so fingers on the buzzers, brains working. Oh, no. 2 points for a right answer, 1 point if I throw it over to you from somebody else. The first few questions have been written specially by Ringo and Paul McCartney. Who played drums on the single of Love Me Do? And this is Ringo's question. Yes, Hank.
Pete Best.
No, it wasn't. Throw it over for one, somebody else. It's David.
Kenny Clare.
It wasn't. It was Andy White. Ringo played on the LP version of it. Andy White played on the single version. What does NEMS stand for? Yes, Hank.
Is it... blah, 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 blah.
No.
Northern English Management or something?
No, it's not. Throw it over for one.
Northern Entertainment Music Society?
No, it was the North End Music Stores, which was originally a furniture shop owned by Brian Epstein's father, and where Paul McCartney's dad bought his first ever piano, so no points there. How many number ones did the Beatles have altogether? Yes, Hank?
17.
17, right, for 2 points. General questions now. Who had London's Hammersmith Odeon gift wrap for Christmas? Yes, John.
Elton John.
Elton John did. Who won this year's Eurovision Song Contest? Who won this year's... Mary?
Germany.
Yes, but what was her name?
Oh, her name. I don't know. Nicole. Nicole.
Yes, Hank.
Nicole.
It was Nicole, yes. A bonus point for acute hearing. Whose first album for years was Coda? Yes, John.
Led Zeppelin.
Led Zeppelin, yes, 2 points. Which American duo reunited this year and played a one-off concert at Wembley, David?
Simon and Garfunkel.
Simon and Garfunkel, yes. 2 points. What were they originally called when they were first... yes.
Tom and Jerry.
Tom and Jerry. Who are the only two artists to have 3 singles enter the charts at number one? Only 2 artists ever done it. John?
The Jam.
Jam.
Slade.
And Slade, yes. 2 points. Last question now. Which TV show did the hits High Fidelity and Star Maker come from? Yes, John?
Fame.
From Fame. 2 points. That's it. The final score, David. Essex team 31, Hank Marvin's team 38. Well, we say thank you very much to David Essex team. They are Mary Wilson. And Leo Sayer. And the skipper, David Essex. Hank Marvin's team have won, and they are kept insensible. I somehow had the feeling that not only Captain Sensible, but also John Taylor from Duran Duran. And their skipper, who's worried that he's going to get covered in this. But of course he isn't. Hank Marvin. Woo! Oh, we're all having fun here. So we'll see you for a new series. We'll see you for a new series. We'll We'll see you for a new series in April, and we'll say goodnight and leave you with a piece of film which was really one of the highlights, I suppose, of 1982, because after 20 years in the business, they're still touring, their first tour for a long time, The Rolling Stones, and Go-Go-Go-Go. See you in April.
Go, go. I love you.